Alright, welcome back to round uno. This hand is unplayable, has no lands. This hand has lands, and may just cast a Gristlebrand at some point in time. I don't mind having my guys in my hand. I have a lot of discard outlets that go from hand and deck and show and tell. So, have a lot of nice little synergy. Alright, I don't really want to draw both of them, but that's okay. We can still gifts for Broodmate Dragon. Gifts and Intuition can also just be cast as real cards, which is, they don't have to be combo pieces. Alright, mildly annoying. Kept open a plane, it's mostly like a sword or something. Maybe mana ties, that'd be weird. Yep. Trying to think of what I'm in intuition for it, I'm not sure. I can't intuition for the combo. I can't intuition for just like Unbarrel Rites and two good cards. I have Corpse Dance, which is a pretty good late game to reanimation spell. But using it early kind of sucks in this deck because I only have three targets, and once they're exiled, I can't reanimate them with the other cards in my deck. So I would much rather like get my Gristlebrand killed by Vindicate and be able to return it again, and then use this as last resort, or when the haste is relevant, or the instant speed. My opponent is not doing anything. He must have like Restoration Angel or something. So I need intuition now unless I want to give him a thing. I don't really care if I give him a thing, to be honest, but I have no idea what I'm intuitioning for. Mostly because I don't know my deck all that well. Alright, let's see. If I get show and tell. No, that would. Probably don't want to get show and tell. I probably just want this to be like him to Turok. Baleful Strix, Frantic Search, and get him with the Frantic Search part. I think that's fine. Very bad intuition. Like I said, we have our combo in our hand, so it's basically just to find some decent stuff type thing. I think the most attractive option here is to give us Frantic Search. Because he doesn't necessarily know what kind of strategy we're playing. He gave me the Strix. Okay. The Strix will help us hit another Black Source. If we have four Black Sources, we can just cast this Gristlebrand. That is an option. If we get another black and another white source down, or two white sources, or two, we need at least one more white source for sure. We can cast the Angel. If I'd gotten Broodmate Dragon there, would he have given it to me? Whoa. Reddit. You guys are gonna see Reddit. He took it. I'm really surprised he gave me baleful strikes. If that's his plan. So, baleful strikes is going to have to be a pretty big game here. We have corpse dance to return it if it comes to that. I would very much not want to do that, but I tapped terribly there. Jesus. Ooh, gifts. So I definitely gifts for the quote-unquote package for Broodmate Dragon on Barrel Rights, I think. You're attacking with the Silver Heart. Interesting. Hopefully, he doesn't do anything too sick here, because if I needed gifts in response, I'm pretty. That's pretty bad. I can't give him multiple things here. What do I possibly do? If I tap this, I'm just screwing myself. I know it. Yeah, I just have to let that resolve and catch him with his pants down. Alright, there's another black source. Maybe we can get this Grizzle Brand into play one way or another. So I gotta play Shadow Mage Infiltrator here. Keep open Gifts and Corpse Dance. I don't think I can respond here. I have to hit a swamp. What I'm hoping to do here is chump, not chump block, but block this, take three, maybe four, and then crack, make sure I get a swamp, and then crack back, and if I don't draw one, to have two shots at it. And hope he has nothing, too. That's another factor. So he could probably get like a Fiend Hunter or something out of it and kill me. Or maybe he doesn't have anything, I doubted. Boom! Got. Oh, jeez. That felt so good. If I attack here, it's not that bad, right? He can't crack. If he cracks, I'm dead. This way I would block this and I would take. This monolith saved my butt, maybe. I think I attack here. Because I need to draw my way out of this. I don't think this guy being back stops it. If he has removal for this, I'm dead. Whoo! Whoo! You don't say! You don't say attacking there was the correct call, Captain! Now I'm only a white source away from casting this chica. After, I mean, we obviously have to untap this and stuff, but. When your opponent plays a scavenging ooze, cast your Gristle Brand and beat him down. Yeah, having both of our fatties in our effectively our opening hand, in our opening seven cards at least, definitely slowed us down to the point where he was able to get this going. But it looks like he might not have an answer because he's in the tank. Even if he has an answer, little does he know, we have will, and we have a force of it. Yeah, this card's less good than this card, but it has combos. All right, I like it. I guess I beat down. See, if I beat down and I draw a white source, I can cast this angel. So maybe I don't beat down. Maybe I just attack with Shadow Mage Infiltrator again. And then if I hit the angel, Agony Warp, I should definitely kill this guy right now. It'll mean I don't have forcible open, sort of, but that's fine. So my plan is to untap this. So the reason I killed the Fauna Shaman there is because any creature he draws potentially turns into an answer to Gristlebrand. I don't know what answers he could have in his deck to other creatures, but you never know. So we're going to untap this. Now I can also attack with Gristlebrand because the crackback won't be lethal. He does get to make his guy a little bit bigger, but... Ooh. Oh, that doesn't get a Plains. Because we already have a Scrubland out. Playing this is actually a trap, I think. So let's go beat down here. Okay, I don't have a Plains in my deck. He's in the tank. I guess playing this isn't a trap. Playing it and breaking it is a trap. So I'll take 5, go to 4, but I got the block here. I could have gifts to that turn. Just trying to get a white source, maybe. I was keeping open mana so I didn't have to pitch gifts to Force of Will. That was what I ultimately decided to do. Because I had a land drop for the turn. But I don't even know if that was correct. I need to get this guy off the board, too. So I basically have to do that with this. Obviously, we block here. Next turn, I could probably attack both. Yeah, I don't need to break that. Islands. Now I can cast Gifts and still have Forceful open. Sweet. So let's cast this first. Should have tapped better. This finds a swamp, though. Oh, it finds underground seed, too. I guess I could have done that last turn. So I just get, show and tell. Yeah, here's what I do. I get show and tell, a white source. Oh no, I can't get a white source. Because if I get it and he doesn't give it to me, then I have to. That's fine, actually. Demonic Tutor. Azorius Chancery. And Orzhov Basilica. It's probably going to be the two lands, which is totally fine. Because Show and Tell doesn't do that much at this point in the game. It's actually kind of a liability. And Demonic Tutor is fine, obviously, but nothing too special. I should not have played my land first, though. That was the mistake there. So yeah, we just attack with this. He's chumpa blocking, sure. So this guy gets slightly bigger. Reasonable play. I think I'm going to go thin out the last swamp. Or I'll get underground sea. Just way better, obviously. I'm actually glad I haven't had to use Force of Will yet, because giving him a token is, like, pretty bad. Encountering a creature means this gets bigger. Misty Rainforest and Birds of Paradise? I don't care about either of those things. He's gonna cast birds again just to buy time, but like that's not getting him very far. I'm netting two off it. Alright, let's go and break this. So, again, I'm just going to attack with this guy. I could go to reanimate his bird and make him get rid of it, but that's not even it. I would have never considered that in the first place, because it's just not a play you need to make most of the time. Alright. So we're good to go. Force of Will up. He's having to make pretty drastic plays just to stay alive at this point. My guy can eat Eternal Witness, which I would probably do, even though it does pump this guy up a little bit. Take 8. Attack back for 7, 8, and then play this. Yeah, I messed up my gifts pile with the double bounce knight. Well, it was actually a fine gifts pile. I just messed up by playing my land first. I will try to reanimate this thing, probably. Do I care about a Fleeceman lion? I don't think so. Why does he have Talarian Academy in his deck? Soaring Shore. That was weird. Juicy! So here we are going to play this first. Let's see what happens. And two more. So probably eat his eternal witness, I would guess, for life. We play this, we pick up island. I have enough for four, so we attack for. I guess I need this for it to be one more. I guess this guy being black, just like. Yeah, I definitely don't need it. I might as well get in the one more, just make sure I have lethal next turn. This guy will get big. That actually wasn't that bad. Because now I have Reman plus Force Will up. Every time I've drawn off of Shadow Mage Elder Church, it's been very good. So this game has been going on forever. It does nothing. Block. All right. Dun 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 dun. When your opponent plays a Scavenging Goose, go over the top. I don't really have anything to bring into any of these matchups. Could bring in Rout. Potentially, I guess. I would definitely want a Plains over. Depends on what I brought in, I guess. I could see taking out Forbid. Guess this. Oh no, this is better. Alright, let's try that. I'm not sure if it's great, but it's reasonable.